In this video, we derive the quotient property of logs, and then we do the following seven problems. We're going to learn the quotient property of logs by deriving it. So let's start in with the log of x base b equal to m, and the log of y base b equals n. So we have a common base. Well, if the log of x base b equals m, we know that means that b to the m is equal to x. And similarly, log of y base b equals n means b to the n equals y. All right, so let's say I wanted to know what the log base b of x over y was equal to. In other words, we're taking the log of a quotient. All right, so what we're going to do is plug in our values for x and y. All right, remember, up here is what x is equal to and what y is equal to. So I have that this is x is the same thing as b to the m, and y is b to the n. All right, so I've really got the log base b of this quotient, b to the m over b to the n. And now I'm going to use my quotient rule with exponents having the same base. I've got b to the m over b to the m. That really means b to the m minus n, doesn't it? Okay, hopefully you see where we're going here. Well, b to the what equals b to the m minus n? Remember, this was one of our properties we've already gone over. This base is the same as that base. The answer is just the exponent, which is m minus n. But what is m? Well, look back up here. M is log of x base b. And n, I'm going to plug in for n, log of y base b. So in the end, what I have here is if I take the log base b of x over y, I get that it's equal to the log of x base b minus the log of y base b. So if you take the log of a quotient, you could write it as the difference of the log of the numerator and the log of the denominator. So it's the log base b of the numerator, so the log base b of the log base b of x minus the log base b of y. All right, so let's write that down. All right, we've got the log base b of x over y is the same thing as the log of x base b minus the log of y base b. Now, caution, that's not the same as log base b of x over the log base b of y. Can't use the quotient rule. This is actually just a, that's not how you spell rule. This is actually a quotient. You're going to have to figure out what this log is and what that log is and then do division. So the difference here is instead of doing the division first, x over y, what you can do is take the log of x minus the log of y. So let's look at an example. All right, let's say you were asked to compute the log base 2 of 32 over 8. Well, simplifying inside parentheses because it's easy, 32 divided by 8 is the log of 4 base 2. And then what would that be? 2 to what power equals 4? That would just be 2, right? So that's what the log of 32 over 8 base 2 is equal to. Now let's use the quotient property. That says you could take the log base 2 of 32 minus the log base 2 of 8. Now, what is the log of 32 base 2? The question is, remember log's just the exponent? 2 to the what exponent equals 32? That'll be 5. And the log of 8 base 2, the question is 2 to what power equals 8? The the power, the exponents, what you're looking for, will be 3. So that's 5 minus 3 is 2. So notice you get the same answer. So there's just an example of where I can use the quotient rule. Here are 3 problems for you to do using the quotient rule. So put the video on pause and try these 3 problems. Okay, let's do them. All right, so we're taking the log base 3 of x sevenths, that's just the log base 3 of the numerator, minus the log base 3 of the denominator, that's all there is to it. Second one, the log base 2 of 10, minus the log base 2 of 11. And the last one, log base x of 2, minus log base x of 7. All right, now we're going to go the other way around. Here are 2 problems for you to try. Write each difference as a single logarithm. Put the video on pause and try this. All right, so we know each difference is the same thing as the log of the quotient. So that means the 5 goes in the numerator and the x plus 1 goes in the denominator. And if you want to clarify, you can put parentheses around that. That's up to you. All right, what about the next one? I need a little more space here. So that'll be the log, the base is 5. Now notice this only works if the base for each log is exactly the same. So in the numerator, I want to have the x squared. And in the denominator, I'll have the x squared minus 1. Can you cancel those x squares? Nope. You can only cancel if everything's factored and it has a common factor. Remember, x squared factors to x times x, whereas x squared minus 1 factors to x plus 1 times x minus 1. So there's no common factors, and if you want, you could put a parentheses around that. So you could leave that with or without the parentheses. That would be the answer. Here are 2 more problems for you to try. Write each expression as a difference of logs and simplify if possible. See if you could try that on your own. Put the video on pause. All right, this first one, we start off with using the quotient property, so the log base 2 of the numerator, which is 8, minus the log base 2 of the denominator, which is x. And by simplify, log of 8 base 2, that simplifies to the number 3, because it's 2 to the third power that equals 8. So in this case, you could actually write this is equal to 3 minus the log base 2 of x. Let's do the next one. Right, so we've got a base of m. Again, we're going to use the quotient rule. So that's the log base m of m to the fifth minus the log base m of 2. And, well, what is the log base m of m to the fifth? Well, 5. That's one of our properties, in fact. But basically, you're saying m to the what power equals m to the fifth? Well, that'll just be 5 minus, and this one we can't simplify, the log of 2 base m. All right, so we have done the product property in the previous video, and now we've done, the product property of logs, and now we've done the quotient property of logs. In this video, we derive the quotient property of logs, and then we do the following 7 problems.